Hey guys, it's Rustic, and today I'm going to teach you how to incorporate kicks into your fight scenes.
We're trained professionals, so take our advice at your own risk. We're showing you how to do action safely, but there's always the danger of getting hurt, so please be safe and use common sense. Also, hit subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.
Now, when it comes to kicking and fight scenes, there are many different styles and experience levels. So today I'm going to show you the basics of how I do it myself. But first, let's start with some safety tips. Always work with your partner. Fight scenes are not about one-upping each other, and the best screen fighters actually work really well with their partner to feel out their rhythm, and they only pick up the pace once they're comfortable with each other. Next, please give each other some space. Kicks and fight choreography require more room than punches. This goes double for you if you're a martial artist. Fight choreography is designed to look fierce and effective while never being truly damaging to your partner. And if you're a filmmaker working with actors or martial artists, make sure you have them walk through the choreography very slowly, several times, and work out their footwork and their pacing and their distancing. And don't start rolling your camera until you're confident with how smooth the rehearsals are looking. Now, the next thing I want to tell you is it's very important to have proper technique when you're doing these kicks. When you're doing sloppy punches in fight scenes, you can get away with it, kind of. But when you're doing kicks, you want them to be really good and sharp and snappy. So learn the proper technique. Okay, guys, so those are all my safety and form tips. Let's just jump right into the tutorial. Okay, so let's start off by looking at how to do a kick to the face. Now, the technique that we always use for selling kicks to the face is called stacking. If you don't know what stacking is, check out the link in the description. There's a tutorial, we've covered it before. But basically, what you're gonna do is, whereas for punches, you can get as close as to a couple inches to the person's face, for kicks, you actually wanna increase that distance for safety. I personally wouldn't go any closer than a foot away from the person's face. Next, paying attention to your foot placement is very crucial. You gotta be able to know how long your legs are and where you need to step on the ground so you don't actually kick your person in the head. All right, so once you got your distance and your form, here's some variations. Action. And a quick note for filmmakers, choosing lower angles when shooting your kicks is gonna make them look much cooler and will emphasize the lines of the body of the performers really well. But if you're gonna do that, make sure you tell your performers so they can adjust the lines of their kicks, because what'll happen is they'll tend to kick a little bit higher than they need to because the camera is so low. Now for kicks to the body, there's actually two ways to sell those hits. You can either stack them like you did for the face, or you can actually make some light contact. If you're working with an actor or somebody brand new to fight scenes, I would just teach them how to use stacking and teach them how to react. So how do you react to a stack body hit? If you get hit in the stomach, that's the first thing that moves and everything else follows. Now the other tip I have for you guys is actually drop with it. Normally kicks don't launch people. If you see some people take a reaction, jump with it, it usually looks really bad. So you want to take the hit and drop with it a little bit. And for you filmmakers, stacked body hits are a little bit harder to sell. So make sure you film it from a little bit further away in order to make sure that everything works for you. And here are some examples of some body hits you can stack. Now, let's talk about making contact. If you're working with people that do have some experience, you will want to make contact because this is gonna look good from any angle, and that's actually my favorite method of selling body kicks. Yeah. So this is actually where your control and your practice comes in. But first, let's talk about pads. When we're getting kicked in the body, we will usually wear pads if we can hide them. Now the different pads you can use are, you can use a small gator back protector, which you can wrap around your chest, your stomach, or any area getting kicked. For the person kicking, if there's gonna be kicks that are gonna be getting blocked, the kicker usually will put on some soft shin pads. And you can also turn these soft shin guards around if you're gonna be sweeping somebody for real. So let's talk about how to make contact on a body kick. Now, as the person kicking, what you actually want to do is tap your opponent on the target. This means that your kick doesn't penetrate or go all the way through. The part of your foot that you hit your opponent with is going to be the flat, nice part of the top of your foot. And this means you need to make sure you're pointing your toe as you're kicking so that part of the foot can tap him and come back. Now the other tip is for the kicker to actually add a little bit of upper body recoil to sell the kick as being harder than it really was. As a person getting hit, what you want to do is you want to tense your stomach, breathe out, and make sure that when you get hit, you add to the reaction. Just taking a hard kick doesn't do good for anyone unless it looks like a hard kick. So help your opponent and actually like react to it, and it's gonna look great.
Now let's talk about push kicks. For front or side push kicks,
what you want to do is you still want to give your opponent the nice part of your foot, in this case the flat bottom, all in one. And you want to place your foot on the opponent and push them away instead of just blasting them with that kick. So when you're blocking your kicks in fight choreography, you want to give your opponent the flat part of your hand so nothing sticks out. So if you're going to use your hand, I would use the soft part of your hand to block a kick, or you can use the back of it, but just make sure your elbow's not sticking out. So leg kicks are usually stacked, mostly used for taking out knees or doing foot sweeps. Three. Just make sure you work out your distance to know exactly where you are so you don't hurt your partner. Kicking somebody while they're on the ground can be tricky, but you can still do it safely with camera. Now, if the person on the ground has the opportunity, I highly recommend they wear some body pads. And with ground kicks, less is more. You don't want to go into just an improv frenzy of just like random kicks. You still want to choreograph what's going to happen so the camera person and the person on the ground can all react in unison. Now for you filmmakers, it can be a little bit tricky to sell ground kicks, so I recommend getting closer with the camera and moving it a little bit more. I actually like to feel the emotion and the space of the guy that's on the ground being kicked. So feeling cramped and kind of adding movement is actually good in this situation. Now every filmmaker is going to use kicks differently, but here's some of my tips. Kicks are long range weapons, so they're great for closing distance into hand fight choreography. Push kicks are great at creating distance between fighters. And special kicks also work great as final blows. And again, when you're working out your fight choreography using kicks, make sure you focus on working out exactly where your feet are going to be placed on the ground, and then walking it through slowly for camera. We've covered a lot in this video today, and I recommend you watch it several times and take notes, but here's some of my main takeaways. So number one, learn good form. Make sure you go practice in the gym, make sure you practice with some people, and make sure your kicks are looking crisp. Remember, it's easier to sell sloppy punches than it is to sell sloppy kicks in a fight scene. Number two, stack further than usual. Your legs are long weapons and they're gonna be closer to the target than you think. So for safety reasons, try to be at least a foot away from your target at any given time. Number three, if you actually are making some light contact, make sure you just tap or push your opponent. Never just blast them with a kick. You don't wanna hurt your partner. Number four, footwork and proper distancing is the key to making kicks look great in fight scenes. And last but not least, safety is always, always, always a priority. If you're working with somebody new and they're just not comfortable with kicks, or maybe they're comfortable with kicks, but for some reason that day they just can't get something right, just change your choreography and move on to something new. You're always gonna look better if you create the choreography for how the person is feeling the strongest that day. All right, guys, and that's our tutorial. Hopefully you learned something useful today. And if you get a minute, make sure to check out my friend Darren. He's also a stuntman and a martial artist, and he makes really cool fight scenes on his channel. So check him out. His link is going to be in the description. Oh, and also check out Frank. He filmed this video for us today. He does really, really interesting vlogs and really cool videos and skits. So anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching. Get out there, start filming, stay safe, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.